Hi, in this video, I'm going to show you how to install ArtConductor for Cubase. I will also show you the basic principles of working with expression maps. So let's get started. Obviously, the first step is you need to download ArtConductor. There are four different files. One contains all the expression maps. Another one contains the East-West Opus instruments you use with East-West Opus Player. A third one contains the snapshots for contact. And the fourth one contains the manuals. Download them all four and store them somewhere safe. Once you have done that and you unzipped all the files, you will have an ArtConductor QS folder. This folder contains the documentation for ArtConductor. And it also contains the expression maps right in here in the ArtConductor QS folder. Now, in difference to other hosts, Cubase doesn't feature a dedicated location for the expression maps. In other words, you can put them wherever you like. I have my expression maps sitting on the desktop right now. To install an expression map, you open the expression maps here. You go to Expression Map Setup, you hit the Load button, you find the ArtConductor Cubase folder, and so you select the expression map you want to load. For this example, I'm going to load the Cinematic Studio Series strings, and I'm using the Violin 1. Now, as you can see, there are two different files. I'm going to explain later what those files do. For now, we just load both. Next, I'm going to load Contact. And I'm looking for the Cinematic Studio strings. And here I'm loading the Violin 1 as well. And now we're all set. The last step is to assign an expression map to this track. We're going right over here in expression map, there's no map. And I'm going to choose the violins and the attribute version. Let's record something. I'm choosing a sustain patch for the recording. And record straight in. Let's have a look. The first thing I do is all those notes are going to be long notes, just to define what they are. If I want to change that to something else, I just select all the notes and I choose tremolo, for instance. Rewind back. And you hear tremolo. I can even make all the notes longs, and only those two are tremolos. It's a bit like having a DVZ section here. Now, I'm working with attributes at the moment. Attributes mean that I can select an articulation per note. But what's about using directions instead of attributes? You remember that I've loaded expression maps for both directions and attributes. Now I'm switching to two directions. And I'm going to expand this area here a little bit so we can see a bit more. Directions mean that I define a point in time, and from this point in time onwards until the next direction is giving, all the notes are playing in a certain style. So for instance here, I want everything to play Marcato for a while. And just for the sake of showing it, from here, I want those to be tremolos. I hope you enjoyed my little demonstration. Please subscribe to our channel. Have a good day. Bye bye.